Thank you for coming to Yoga with Pretty Zen. This is my dog, Butter. He might join us a little bit in this evening's practice. We're gonna start our practice by coming to our mat. And we're gonna actually start in Shavasana. So lay down on your mat, straight on your back, Butter. I need you to sit. Butter, I need you to sit. Lay back straight on your mat and close your eyes. Down.
No.
Butter. As you lay on your mat, bring attention to the breath. As you inhale, intention for today's practice. My intention today is just to be free and to let go of the week as I go into the weekend. Freeing myself of judgment and even freeing myself from the expectations of this video. Maybe your intention is to just have fun. Maybe it's just self-care, spending some time with yourself, doing something good for yourself. Bringing awareness to the breath as your abdomen moves up. Stretch out your arms wide ahead of you and stretch out your toes and point them towards the bottom of the mat. Now flex them and open the fingers wide. Ball your fingers up and point the toes again. Release the fingers down. And let the shoulders melt to the mat, giving yourself a little bit of a back stretch here, maybe leaning into the back. When you're ready, bring your arms to the side of your hips and allow yourself to push up slowly and gently. We start today's practice on our knees in Hero. Knees should be hip width apart. Drawing in the belly. Chest open. Let's take a few breaths here. And on our next inhale, your arms will raise up to the sky. Inhale up, arms together, and arms up to the sky. you're ready to draw the belly in and keeping the hands close to the ears. On the exhale, push the hips back, extend the arms out, coming into child's pose. If you need to open your hips a little bit more, you can create some space there. Allow the forehead to drop down to the mat and extend through the arms, breathing. Move your arms back in close to your knees and go ahead and sit back up into hero. Inhale all the way up, palms together. Inhale, and on your exhale, give yourself a little back bend towards the back. Just a little. Stretch here. Exhale back down. We're going to come onto table with our hips shoulder width apart, hands hip width apart, neutral spine. Inhale and release the left leg up for fire hydrant. Exhale and bring it down. Inhale up and exhale down. Inhale up, fire hydrant. Remembering to flex the foot and exhale down. One more time, inhale up. And exhale down. We're gonna do the same thing on the other side. So shifting our body weight to our lefts. Inhale up on the right side for fire hydrant up. And exhale down. Inhale the right leg up, kicking like you're peeing on a fire hydrant, like you're a dog. And exhale down. Inhale. And exhale down. Inhale up, remembering to flex the foot and keeping the legs engaged. And exhale down. We're gonna do some cat-cows here. We're gonna inhale and push up into cow, arching the back, drawing the navel in towards the spine, and exhale, cow, as we lift the tailbone and our gaze goes up. Inhale, cat, again, rounding the spine, pushing through the arms, and exhale, cat. Cow. Exhale, cow. Looking up to the ceiling. Pushing that tailbone up. Inhale, cat. Again, rounding the spine, pushing through the arms. And exhale, cow. Tuck your toes under as we prepare for our down dog. Push through the arms and lift the hips into a V position. Pedal the legs to give your glutes a deeper stretch. Allow your head to hang low. To pushing through your arms, shoulder blades pulling apart. Stop in the middle, look between your hands, and step the left leg up, coming into a high lunge. Release the hands from the ground by your ears. Hold high lunge for a few breaths. Rotate the back leg towards the wall and extend the arms out parallel to the mat. Looking over your front arm, gaze should be over the middle finger. Warrior two. Drop the left arm down to the mat with the right arm extended up. Straighten the left leg out, coming in to triangle. Gaze should be at the top hand. Okay. Right arm comes down to meet the left hand. Left arm goes back to where it was, framing the foot. Drop the right knee down and go ahead and untuck that back leg, releasing your arms up into the sky for a crescent lunge. Heart should be open and engaged. Down to the mat, coming up on the right, take the right knee off the mat, coming back up into a low lunge, and step the left leg back to meet the right. Both arms are going to bend, coming down for chaturanga. Belly meets the mat, toes go back under, and push up for cobra.
Again, letting the head and neck hang, shoulder blade pulling apart. This time, look up to your hands and step the right leg between your hands. When you find your balance, go ahead and release the hands from the ground all the way up into a high lunge. Remembering to breathe here. Go ahead and ground the left foot. 45 degree angle. Coming into extend the arms out parallel, gazing over your right arm and your right middle finger for warrior two. Remember to breathe. You're going to drop the right arm down to the mat as the left arm folds up, extending the right leg straight for triangle. left arm meets right. Right arm goes, right hand goes back to frame the foot. The back leg turns back straight. And go ahead and lean back down for a low lunge on the right side. Remembering to extend the spine, lengthening. Drop the left leg down. Go ahead and tuck up, put the foot back normal instead of having it tucked. And when you find your balance, release, arms up high, opening the heart for crescent lunge. Arms go back down, framing the foot, step back up, curling the toes on your left side. Right foot meets the left foot back. Now you're in plank, and again, chaturanga, down to the floor, belly meets the mat, toes turn under, you push up for cobra. Extend the arms, push back on the hips. Dropping the head, extending the arms until the head meets the mat, coming into child's pose. Stay here for a few breaths. Coming back up to table, tucking the toes under, pushing up at the hips. Remembering to engage in our core as we drop our heads and let it hang and allow our heels to touch the mat if we can. Float the left leg up for a three-legged dog. And breathe. Bend the left knee back. Allowing the hip to open for a three-legged dog hip opener. On your next exhale, bring the leg back down. And put it back on the mat. On your next inhale, float the right foot up for a three-legged dog. Hips should be square. Bend the right knee and let it go behind you for a hip stretch here on the right side. Three-legged hip stretch. And when you're ready, exhale and release it. Let down to the mat. Come back up to table. Come back up to table. Pushing the hips back again. And child's pose once more. Back up to table, tucking the toes under, pushing up into downward dog. Float the left leg up. Bend the left knee back. And allow the leg to slowly fall behind you as you lift the left hand off the mat, coming into Wild Thing as you open up the chest. Lifting and breathing. Pushing strong through the right hand. Bring the body back down, parallel. Whew. Come
coming back to the mat. And down dog. Float the right leg up for a three-legged dog. Bend the right knee. And again, allow the right leg to slowly fall behind you until it meets the mat. While you slowly lift the right hand up, over and back, opening the heart for a wild thing. And back up. Go ahead and let the knees touch the mat and push back for child's pose. Releasing from child's pose, come back up into hero, sitting at the back of your mat. Go ahead and come up standing. And come into the center of the mat for garland. Your feet a little wider than shoulder width apart. I'm tall, so I definitely have those shoulders apart. And then you bend down, trying to keep your heels on the mat. Transition from our garland into ninja pose. So we're going to drop the left, we should extend the left leg out as we shift our weight on our right, ensuring that our left toe is flexed and extended, our left foot. Go ahead and give ourselves a side stretch while we're here, dropping our right hand to the ground and extending over while we rotate our leg. Okay. Back to ninja, flexing that foot. Bring that left leg in. No bubba. Going to extend the right leg out, flexing the foot for a ninja on the other side. Sorry about my fur babies, they just went a little tonight. This time dropping the left and extending. Back into center, garland. I'll take one more breath on this side, and then go ahead and extend that left leg back out for ninja. Bring the left leg back in for garland. One more time on the other side. And come into ninja. And this time we're gonna go ahead and do that side stretch again. Dropping our right hand, putting that foot flat. Garland, not to the right. Oh, can you move? And then I'll stretch it. Back into Garland. Thank you. We're gonna push up or take your arms and put them in front of you and go ahead and extend your legs out. Or a little bit of like a V stretch. Drop the head until it meets the mat. And float the foot up if you can. If not, you can get on a wall. All the way up. Hold. Eagle pose here, my legs. I don't know what's wrong with my foot. It really hurts when I try to flex it. And the other side. Okay. When you're ready, slowly release the legs down. And back to the floor. Slowly lift the head off the mat. Bring the feet back in. Allow yourself to go into ragdoll in this kind of hand. Ragdoll for the side view. You're just literally, you know, standing straight. Hips, and then just allowing your body to hang, whatever it may be. It's okay to have a little micro bend in the knees. Just allow your body to hang and melt. Inhale and bring the body all the way up. All the way up. All the way up. And bring the arms down to the side, coming into mountain. For mountain, you don't want to have your booty all stuck out like this. You want it your tail tucked in. You want your abdomen drawn in. I want to engage your core. It's harder than it looks. For mountain, we're going to extend our right leg out into the front, pointing our toe, and hold. Bend the right knee back. Slowly extending it out as the body goes forward and the hands go forward for warrior. Warrior three. Drop the left hand down to the mat or use a block if you need to. Extend the right arm up, foot parallel to the mat for half moon. Gazing at the mat or at your hand if you can. The hand at the top. Grab the back foot
for sugarcane pose at the ankle and hold. Front foot should be pointed up to the front of the mat. Micro bend at the knee and lift the hands off the ground slowly, keeping the bottom leg straight for dancer if you can. Whew. That was rough, y'all. For dancer, if you again. My little legs are tired. Release the leg back to the mat and shake it out. I know that was kind of a lot on one leg. So, let's do it again, but we're gonna do the opposite side this time. So coming into mountain, making sure our toes are spread apart, hip width apart. Again, we don't want our booties pressed out. We want our tailbone tucked in, core engaged. Standing in mountain, chest raise. Inhale and lift that left leg up straight to the sky, or straight in front of you, parallel, working on the muscles right in here. And bend that left knee back, slowly making it straight as you move your hands out. Four, three. Lifting the chest. Drop the right arm down to the mat or block if you need to. Once your arm is secure, lift that left arm up, coming into half moon. Oops. This is one of my least favorite poses, by the way, but gotta work on it. Grabbing that foot with the hand that is back there, coming into sugarcane. And then lifting the chest and the hand from mat, coming into dancer. Whew, that's rough. But it's practice, so it's all good. Okay. Releasing that from, release all of that out, because that was just a lot for my legs. We're going to go ahead and sit on our mat, taking an easy seat. I think that was a lot. I think that was enough for us. Definitely enough for me. We'll give ourselves a little bit of a stretch. So reach up to the sky, maybe interlocking the fingers, keeping the back as straight and as long as possible. Look up to your fingers and lift straight down, hinging at the hips. Extend. Maybe don't do your fingers like that, just extend them. And reach as far as you can. Okay, release. Go ahead and take your right arm and put it behind you. Go lay down, baby. Go lay down. Take your left arm and put it on your right knee. Butter. Go lay down. And you're gonna twist. Give yourself a little twist. twist. Remembering to be sit up straight. And release.
This time take your left hand, put it behind you, and your right hand on your left knee. Inhale tall as you can, and on the exhale, twist to the left side. Take both of your hands, put them behind you. Push up at your hips. Drop the head back. Pushing up on your fingertips if you need to. And allow yourself to get the stretch in the hips. And down. Extend the right leg out. Breathe up and inhale and exhale and fold over to the right. And release. Take the right leg and put it over the left knee and take your right elbow and put it on your knee to give yourself a little twist for half of the Lord of Fishes, or Lord of the Fishes, whatever this is called. The other way if you like, just to get another different type of stretch. Perfect. Release that leg back down to the, come back into easy seat. Now release the left leg out. Inhale up and exhale
down to the left side, holding and remembering to breathe.
Release and come up. Take that left leg, put it over next to your right knee. Take your, take your right elbow and put it on your knee and twist. Take both legs, extend them out for a straddle. Inhale up and exhale, forward fold at the hip, stop butter.
All the way down.
Trying to make your belly meet the floor. Bring both feet together for butterfly. I like to rock in my butterfly. Yeah. Sitting up straight, allowing the hips to stretch butter. While you're in butterfly, go ahead and butter. I said no. That's gonna be our last little pose for today. We're gonna go into Shavasana. So go ahead and lay back. Find yourself in a comfortable position. releasing any tension. Really just how loose it probably is from our practice. Noticing the toes, the feet, the ankles, the shins, the thighs, our fingertips, noticing our abdomen as it moves up and down with the breath. Noticing our chest and even our heart as it beats to keep us alive, pump blood throughout our body. Notice what areas may be feeling warm right now in this moment. Thank you. watching this video and for spending time with yourself and taking care of yourself today. I apologize for my dog and his attitude. Mr. Boss needs to go sit down now. But it happens, being a dog mom. Again, I thank you. I express gratitude.